Forever, ever, hold it, never mind. Oh, I. Hello, hello, कैसे हैं आप लोग? I welcome you all to Soul Star of today. You know, we are going to do a soulmate, twin flame kind of vibe. Current energy is basically what your person is really going through. Masculine, feminine, doesn't matter. No genitalia, as I said, I always say that on the channel, okay? There's no genitalia. I'm going to keep this reading in English and I'm going to see what is the reaction I receive for the same, because a few people suggested that, you know, do a reading in English as well. So let me just keep this in English. So having said that, adab, namaste, sastrikal, greetings to everybody watching the channel. My new joiners, I welcome you on board. Thank you so much. I love you guys to bits. My old joiners, I send you so much of love and light. Thank you for supporting the channel. We are growing, the community is growing. We're very close to 200 subscribers. Please do like and subscribe if you haven't liked the channel as of now. And do press the bell icon as well. That really, really means a lot, okay? So we are tapping into your current energies. And there are no reversals that we do on this. We're going to use the Power of Love deck and we're going to take out about 3 cards. And then we're going to talk about what exactly the energy is feeling and trying to communicate. Could be your energy, could be the person you're thinking about. It could be their energy, okay? You can already be in an equation of the same, or somebody is walking into your life in the similar light. So let me know whichever way it resonates, okay? So there were people, you know, there are 2-3 people who in fact wrote to me, and I'm going to make a quick mention. There is this wonderful gentleman who wrote to me that, you know, please do something on, do twin flames cheat, okay? And is your twin flame your true love? And also, you know, it was suggested that please tell us, what does Bible say about twin flames? So I thought, let me just pull out the same reading and also talk about this a little, you know. So I'll start with exactly as to what does the Bible really say, because what has happened today is that, you know, people take it very conveniently. They feel that, you know, it's convenient to have. Don't get me wrong, all right, and even if you do, it really doesn't matter, because, you know, everybody is free for their opinion. It's free will, right? So people today use twin flame soulmate kind of connections for their own easy and comfort base, okay, to have an extramarital affair or to get into a relationship because they just want to. So they talk about soulmate energies and all of that, but they don't understand that there's a bigger purpose to it, right? So Jesus says in Matthew 19:6, people who are aware would know and understand that, you know, they are no longer two, but one flesh, okay? So it is actually like, that it's like two bodies, right? But one soul. You know, their masculine energy and the feminine energy, of course, separated. But as I said, you know, they don't make an effort to change each other because they're very much the same. They're made up of the same fiber, fabric, everything. They come together to make one soul and to make a better, purposeful life. Because if you come together, as the same Bible inscribed, that you can bring about huge changes, you can invite amazing abundance into your life, right? And going further, that whether a twin flame cheats or doesn't cheat is that, yes, that happens. That really happens when one is awakened and the other is not, okay? If the other one is not awakened as the one, then of course there is a possibility that you won't find it uncommon that cheating does happen. But you run back to the same one because you know that you found the one, you found the right one, okay? So let me pull out 3 cards as to what are the current energies, what are they thinking about you. Masculine, feminine, could be you. Take it the way it comes to you, the one in context you're thinking about, the one who's coming your way. Please watch the other reading that you've done on the channel already. I'm going to pin them, okay? Subtitles will be only on, you know, once we cross certain viewership and etc. And I want to grow the channel organically, honestly speaking. I've got the ways to kind of pump in the money and, you know, promote it, but I don't want to do that. I really want people to understand and appreciate the channel and show that support also, okay? So if you really like it, do help us grow. So going forward, I'm going to pull this now for you, okay? As to what exactly they want to tell you and what you need to tell them, either way. क्रॉस वॉचर्स प्लीज वॉच इट एज पर योर अंडरस्टैंडिंग. ओके सो वी हैव द पास्ट. Wow, and we have the commitment. So much about the sacral chakra. You guys are very attracted to each other for now, you know. So that is why maybe, you know, it's more on the physical level, physical plane that you're still trying to understand, guys. You're still trying to figure out as to really what this connection is about and how deep this is and what is the essence of it. So I'm going to dive in deeper. Wait a second, okay? Let me pull out the third one. And let me know whether the English reading works well with you guys. I'll get to know through your views, and you know, if there's a comment, I'll get to know. Wow. And we have satisfaction. So it's about the heart, the sacral, and of course the root as well, the chakras that I see around working. So you know what? With the past here, it's through the power of love, you release any stagnant situations or energy in order to transform your heart space. So yes, it is about healing your heart. It is about, you know, getting into that awakened state. And of course, it's a soulmate twin flame kind of vibe, as I said, that the person you're thinking about or the one you're watching this for possibly is telling you the same thing, that you've shared past lives together. You had that connection. You understand that, you know, there is that connection that you guys have, and that is the power of love. Celine Dion actually sang a song. Love come to those who believe, and that's the way it is. Something like that. So you got to believe in the fact that this is the one, and you'll have to let the energy work for you, because you're not letting it happen because you're holding on to a lot of past engagements, a lot of past situations and all of that. And with the commitment here, going forward, says the same thing, that, you know, you dedicate yourself to your beliefs wholeheartedly, knowing that love is the essence of your very being. I'm repeating it. You can take the screenshot also if you want to. You dedicate yourself to your beliefs wholeheartedly, knowing that love is the essence of your very being. That it's true. Radha or Krishna, Shiva, Parvati, Michael or Holy Spirit, they said the same thing, that the essence is love. You cannot change the one you think is your twin. You cannot change the one who's your soulmate. You cannot expect them to change because they are projecting you. So there's a lot of run and chase game that happens, you know, in these connections. That is why that happens, and that is why you keep doubting that, really, is that my twin? Is this my soulmate? And you know, fall into the traps of so many usual, you know, materialistic things. And there are zodiac signs, you know, that are considered to be twin flames per se. Sagittarius and Geminis, you know, they understand, specifically one example I'm giving you, on a completely different level. And both signs have this amazing, strong need of freedom. They want to be free. They can't be caged, right? But despite being the element that they are, like, so different, Gemini, as we know, is an air sign, and Sagittarius happens to be a fire sign. They're so different. But yet their call to be together is so, so similar. Similarly, you know, Aquarius and Virgos, they have that kind of vibe together. And they are again like an amazing matches for the same. Once you understand the higher purpose, and once you have your head, your heart aligned, you have that amazing satisfaction knowing that, oh, you know what, this is my twin or soul mate connection, and I have nothing to worry, because then you're letting the energy guide you. You're not being ruled by anything else. Nothing will plague you, nothing will brainwash you, nothing will affect you. Because you will not question the connection anymore. You will trust the connection, you know. So I think the message that here I see is that right now, you or the other person that we're talking about, the energy we're talking about, is questioning the connection, all right. We end up questioning so much. So presumably the last reading that I did was current energies. in the context, I'm going to pin it, what I really read, because I do a lot of reading, right? So it gets a little different because personal readings also happen. So I'm going to pin it, but I think the vibe was the same, that, you know, they really want to, they know this, but, you know, there's this sense of doubt. They're still buying time. They're getting ready. So, of course, that kind of energy is playing. So I'm going to pull out the tarot and I'm going to use a Mystic Monday. I'm going to pull out the tarot and I'm going to see exactly who are we dealing with, okay? And if not, who is coming that way? But I think this is about someone you're dealing with right now. Let's see. Michael, show the message. Guys, show the message. Just see the people on the journey. What are the current energies? Yeah, they need to see what are the current energies. They need to see what are the upcoming supporting energies. They need to see in this connection. What are they trying to convey? What are they trying to say? Turmoil explained. That's what they're saying. That confusion, chaos and conflict explained. Chaos and conflict can explain. That's what they're saying. Because that's the advice. If not, they're saying that is going to be resolved, because you will let the energy guide you. You will not be guided by anything else, by people, by situations, but you'll let the energy guide you, right? So I'm gonna do two more shuffles. And I hope you guys are safe in COVID, guys. Stay home, stay safe, be responsible. I send lots of love and light to you and your family members and the loved ones. We are offering healing. I'm doing a collective healing session for people who are suffering from COVID and otherwise also going through a lot of mental trauma. And we talk about physical wellness, emotional wellness as well. So you can leave the names of the people you want the healing for free, hashtag free, in the comment box, and like and subscribe to the channel, and I'm going to send you a message once we send the healing, okay? So let's see what are the messages we need to see, Michael. So what's the message we need to see? And now I just saw turmoil explained. Why? Let's see. Now tell me, we have like a true pair. You know, we have like a true pair. And this is undoubtedly what, you know, I love my guides here. I love them. Why? Because they are so, so accurate when they deliver the message, you know. So by the new moon that we are entering into, we are going to enter new moon in Taurus. Do watch your reading for the new moon in Taurus, for all love signs and encapsulated reading, and separate reading I have done. Encapsulated reading I have done for Mercury into Gemini. So do watch that. Watch your sun, moon and rising astro placements, of course. But you know, twin flame soulmate readings or these current energy readings are basically very intuitive readings, very psychic readings, okay? So having said that, we have a true pair here. I have an emperor and I have an empress. So when I say an empress, who is the empress? Someone who is abundant. She's all queens wrapped into one, okay? Pentacles, cups, wands, swords. She's wrapped into one. So is the emperor. So maybe a Taurus, a Gemini, an Aquarius, you're dealing with strong, that I see. With the empress, I see again a similar energy, Cancer, Virgo, Taurus, Aquarius, I see, okay? So it's a true pair. Whoever you're thinking about or whoever you are in connection with is quite a true pair, okay? And they're saying that you both still need to realize, because you both are of the similar energy. You both are made of the similar metal, but one is the Princess of Cups and the other is the magician. So you both have that ability, that power to manifest what you want. So your turmoil, your confusion, A forces explain that yes, twin flames exist, okay, and yes, they are for real, and yes, you guys have past, you've shared past lives together. So you're dealing with a strong water sign, you're dealing with a strong, you know, I've stated the same, Taurus, Virgo, Gemini, Cancer energy, could be an Aries as well. So you're dealing with someone who knows that you are the one, or the person is the one. Take it as it resonates, okay? So if this is not a story, do not fix it and do not try to kind of, you know, be into it. You can escape it as well. I see a lot of substance abuse someone is using. Please don't get into that. Please let go of it. Substance abuse doesn't mean you're eating and popping something in your mouth. It can be your thought process also. You know, let go of a thought process which is not serving you right now to understand the intensity of your relationship, because you guys are indeed a true pair. It's just that you're not letting the energy guide you. Let the energy guide you so that you can see the real thing from the heart space. So use the eyes of the heart to understand the turmoil, okay? I'm going to repeat this. They're making me say this. My guides are making me say this. Use the eyes of the heart to see the beauty of the connection, to understand the turmoil, okay? And by the new moon in Taurus, you would have a decent amount of clarity, and you would know exactly what you're supposed to do and how you're supposed to take it. So maybe this is like the testing time. This is like the testing phase for you, okay? So I think an amazing reading for you guys. I am just kind of attracted, you know, to actually pull out one note, really, from notes from the universe as to what is the law of attraction talking, you know, what is it suggesting. Let's just see to that also, because I think that will give you much needed hope to work on the connection. Because we end up doubting, right? We end up questioning, we end up not understanding, and we end up staying in the chaos and conflict stage. And at times, you know, we let go of someone who's really the right one, because it's all illusion, right? So maybe this can help. So Michael, show me, what is the notes from the universe that the soul tribe that's watching, that's resonating, that is on the journey, needs to see. Let's see. You definitely are with someone who is the right one. You've shared past lives together, you know, and could be some regression which is holding you back, not to realize, not to be in that strong, solid commitment and giving wholeheartedly, you know. You have to give in wholeheartedly, but again, you know, you should not rush and go with the Knight of Pentacles kind of energy, I feel. And it says that my energy creates my reality. What I focus is what I will manifest. So it's so true. They're saying that you know it. You simply know it, but it's just that you're not, you know, paying much attention because you're plagued right now. So like I said, you know, turmoil explained, simply speaking, current energies, turmoil explained, your confusion explained, but they're saying focus on the energy with the satisfaction. You're also saying the same thing, that let the energy guide you, let the energy take you forward. It's like the halo which becoming, right, like an angelic thing. So angels are guiding this. They're saying that, you know, let the energy guide you. And don't let people, experiences, situations define it. Because this is like a true pair. An emperor and an empress self. Have a look. I can't manipulate it. It's so strong a relationship. Or so strong a bond, right? So, could be the one you already have in your life. Or maybe someone is coming into your life, in your reality. That is going to manifest, okay? So just be open to it with the new moon in Taurus that we're moving in. Do watch the new moon readings for all love signs. You'll get a better picture, better clarity. And whatever you focus and whatever you put your intentions in, you can manifest, and we have it twice. We have the magician here, and that's what the notes from the universe is saying, that you can manifest whatever you want. So thank you so much. If the reading resonates, give us a like and subscribe. And this is the English reading that I have done on request of people. And yes, there's this person who subscribed, wonderful, sweet one, DJ In. I'm forgetting the name, but let me just see. The name of the person is, one second, guys. I think it is young lad, you know, who wrote in as well. And so I'm just, give me one second, okay? And you can escape it too if you want, but maybe I'm not pronouncing it right. So DJ In, whoever has subscribed and sent a message, thank you so much. Just now, I just gave a shout out. Thank you, and I shall see you the next time. Bye for now.